Yeah, so Rutherford model, what Rutherford told that all the masses of atom, maximum that is 99.99% of masses are concentrated in center of the atom, that is the nucleus, okay? And around which electrons they revolve just like our planetary system. Nucleus is the sun, and all the planets, electrons represent just like planets, they revolve around the nucleus, okay. And we also calculated and saw that the distance between your nucleus and the orbit of electron, that is the radius of the orbit, is more than 10 raised to 5 times that of your radius of the nucleus, okay. So most of the space is empty, clear. So Rutherford, what he told, that electrons are revolving around the nucleus, okay, all the electrons, and most of the masses are concentrated in the center, that is what we call as nucleus. Now there was a problem in this model, okay. So what are the problems with this planetary model? Problems with Rutherford model. Problems with Rutherford model. Yeah, so let us see what are the problems with Rutherford model. We know that whenever a charged particle accelerates, okay, so whenever a charged particle accelerates, then it radiates energy, electromagnetic energy, electromagnetic wave, and then its energy decreases and it becomes zero. Okay, so every accelerating charged particle emits electromagnetic radiation. Now, according to Rutherford model, this is nucleus and electrons are revolving around. Clear? That means electrons are continuously accelerating. There is centripetal acceleration always whenever any object is revolving around certain point, then we have the associated acceleration, that is the centripetal acceleration. Okay. And because acceleration is there, so this electron must emit some electromagnetic radiation. And because of which electromagnetic radiation means just like photon, okay, it will radiate photons. So energy packets, that means its own energy will decrease. Okay, so the energy associated with electron must decrease, and instead of revolving in the perfect circular orbit, it should revolve like this, and finally it should go and that means attracted by the nucleus, and it should.
Sir, rule number four present.
Once again, I will tell those who have come now. Attendance I have not taken. Attendance I will take afterwards. Okay. In between, so be present all the time. If you leave the class, when I will take attendance, that I also don't know. Okay. Jab man kiya tab attendance loga, you have to be present all the time. Otherwise, you will be marked absent. Most of you are running away after 5 minutes. That's why I need to apply this method. So now listen here carefully. This electron, suppose it is moving around the nucleus, then instead of moving in the circular orbit, it should have moved in this spiral way, and then it should go and collide with nucleus. Why? Because its energy must be radiated through electromagnetic wave, because it is known that accelerating charged particles always emit electromagnetic radiation. Clear? Accelerated charge particle always emit electromagnetic radiation. So because of that, this, instead of moving in the circular path, it should move in this way, and then it should go and collide with the nucleus, attracted by the nucleus. That should be the ultimate, okay, the last step of the revolving of the electron. But that is not actually happening. Instead, electrons are moving in the circular path. They are not going and combining with the nucleus. That is not what is happening actually. So basically, the theory that is given by Rutherford is not a complete theory. Okay. And one more thing, whenever these electrons are radiating electromagnetic wave, suppose at this distance, this is the radius R. Okay. Whatever frequency it is radiating, that frequency is same as the frequency of the revolution of the electron. Now, when the electron comes here, this is nucleus now, suppose after some time, and electron is here because its radius is now this one. So obviously the radius has decreased. So as the radius decreases, its frequency increases. We know thread mein leke aaj experiment karo, you take a thread and tie a stone, and then if the thread is longer, it revolves at a slower speed. Jaise hi usko thread ko chota kar do, with the same force you have applied, okay, you will see that it is revolving at faster speed. That means frequency has increased. Okay, so whenever the electron is coming towards the nucleus, its frequency increases because the velocity increases. Okay, that means the frequency which is emitted must be higher than the initial one. Okay, but it is found, it is not found in that way, because we have already seen the spectral lines, they are constant throughout. Okay, whatever lines you have, they are constant and it is not changing over time. Okay, whatever spectral lines we have for hydrogen element now, maybe after 10 days you do, same thing you will get. Maybe after 2 hours you do, same thing you will get. Okay, so the spectral lines don't change. That means this Rutherford model is not complete. Something is missing in this model. Okay, so to provide the explanation, good explanation, Bohr, another physicist, he gave some postulates. Okay, he gave some postulates, and based on those postulates, he could explain these shortcomings very easily. Okay, so what are those postulates? Let us see. Bohr's postulate. So Rutherford's model, Rutherford's postulates were like all the masses were concentrated at center and electrons are revolving around, just like planetary system. Okay, now Bohr, he gave some different ideas. Okay, he gave some different postulates, which are like this. First postulate is, electron in an atom could revolve in certain stable orbits without the emission of radiant energy. Okay, so what he told, Bohr, what he told, that nucleus is there, then there are certain orbits, okay, there are certain orbits, fixed orbits, around which if electron revolves, then it will not emit any kind of energy. Okay, this is the first postulate. So atoms, each atom, it has definite stable states. Okay, so for example, see, electrons is moving here. Suppose hydrogen, let us take, this is simple case of your hydrogen atom, then electron is moving in this fixed state. Okay, so this is one of the stable state of the atom. Suppose electron is going to any higher orbit and revolving, this is one more state of the atom. Clear? So likewise, we have, each atom has some definite states, okay, in which it can exist. So this is one of the state of the atom, this is another state of the atom. Likewise, in any atom can have multiple states, okay, which are called as your stationary states of the atom. Clear? So let me write that sentence. So electron in an atom could revolve in certain stable orbits without the emission of radiant energy. Okay, so if electrons are there in that state, in that orbits, then they will not radiate any kind of energy. That is his first postulate. Okay, so each atom has definite stable states, and these states are called as stationary states of the atom. Okay, that part I will not write. So this is his first postulate. Okay, so there are fixed orbits around the nucleus. If the electrons are moving in that fixed orbits, then there is no emission of any kind of electromagnetic energy. Okay, then second postulate, what was his second postulate, is that The electrons revolve around the nucleus only in these orbits, for which the angular momentum is some integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Okay, so what it says that the electrons, so these electrons which are moving in the orbit, the electrons revolve around the nucleus only in those orbits. Which orbits अभी define कर रहे हैं वो orbit को, what are those orbits? Okay, second postulate defines those orbits. Okay, so only those orbits for which the angular momentum is some integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Clear? So electrons orbit, now what are those orbits? We know that electrons orbit in certain revolve in certain orbits, and then it does not radiate any kind of energy. So which are those orbits? That is defined by second postulate, which states that those orbits, these are those orbits for which the angular momentum is some integral multiple of h by 2 pi. That is angular momentum L is equal to n h by 2 pi, integral multiple n. Okay, so that means where n is, n can be 1, 2, 3, anything. Okay, n is 1, 2, 3, 4, anything it can be. Any integral number, okay? So this is your second postulate, which defines those orbits. What are those orbits? Clear? Now come to third postulate. So these are two postulates. Now third postulate is, yeah, what is this third postulate? An electron might make a transition from one of its specified non-radiating orbit to another lower energy orbit, and when it does so, a photon is emitted in the process. Okay, having energy equal to the differences in the energy. Very simple. So what it is saying, suppose I'll explain it first. This is the nucleus, and this is one of the orbit where electron can revolve. May not be revolving now. Okay. This is the orbit which is possible, jisme electron revolve kar sakta hai. Now this is one more orbit maybe, where one more electron can also revolve. Okay, suppose initially electron was here, this is the stable orbit, and this is one more stable orbit.
Humko pata hi nahi tha 8 baje ye kabhi kabhi 9 baje shuru karte kabhi 8 baje shuru karte biology ka tha.
Saloni Priya, माइक ऑफ करो अपना. ओके, सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन दैट इज रिवॉल्विंग, लेट अस से. ओके, एंड सपोज इट मेक्स अ ट्रांजिशन, यहां पे आ जाता है इलेक्ट्रॉन ना, देन देयर इज सम चेंज इन एनर्जी स्टेट. यहां पे जितना एनर्जी था इलेक्ट्रॉन का, इट इज नॉट देयर हियर. There is some change in energy. So whatever is the change in energy, that much is radiated in the form of electromagnetic wave. Okay. So whenever the electron makes a transition from one state, one orbit to another, one stable orbit to another, then the difference in energy is the energy of your electromagnetic radiation or photon, specifically you can say, which it emits in the process. Okay, gamma ray maybe, or X-ray, whatever ray it is. Clear? So only in these situations only the electrons, they radiate energy. Otherwise, while revolving, it does not radiate any kind of electromagnetic wave. Okay, or radiant energy. Clear. So whenever it is making a transition from one orbit to another, then only it radiates energy. Okay, and how much energy? It is same as the difference in the energy of this orbit, first orbit to second orbit. Okay, similarly, from one orbit to another, if it wants to go, then in the same way, if some kind of photon is coming and striking it, it is absorbing energy and it is going to higher level. Okay, higher level does not mean upar bahar ki taraf, andar ki taraf bhi ho sakta hai. Okay, whatever it is. So whenever it is gaining some energy from photon, specific energy only, okay, photon of specific energy, then it is going to higher orbit. Okay, so this is the way electron is emitting radiant energy or absorbing radiant energy. Clear? So this is the third postulate. Let me write this one again. So an electron might make a transition. An electron might make a transition from one of its specified, from one of its specified non-radiating orbits to another orbit to another. Okay, and another of lower energy, and when it does so, okay, when it does so, a photon is emitted having energy equal to the energy difference between equal to the energy difference between the initial and final states. Okay, the initial and final state. And what can be the frequency of that radiating photon electromagnetic wave? It is, we can get the expression from h nu is the energy associated with a photon. So h nu is equal to energy of the initial state, initial orbit, minus energy of electron in final orbit. This is the equation which relates frequency of the radiating photon in terms of your energy. Okay, that is initial state, initial orbit mein kitna energy tha electron ka, and final state mein kitna energy tha electron ka. Okay, that is what this equation represents. Clear? Yeah, quickly I will take attendance. Only once I will call out the name. Jo speak out nahi kiya uska absent mark karenge and we'll move on. Yeah, section B. Be ready. Section B, Abhishek Mina. Adil Khan. Abhishek Mina present hai. Simply on karke bhag gaya hai. Adil Khan. Aditi Tomar. Amit.
Present, sir.
Ankit Singh.
Present, sir.
Arpita Killer.
Present, sir.
Ayan Khan.
Sir, Abhishek Mina present, roll number 1.
Yeah, Abhishek Mina. Ayan Khan not there. Bharat Kumar.
Present, sir.
या दक्षिता नॉट देयर. देव शर्मा
प्रेजेंट सर.
दक्षिता प्रेजेंट, देव शर्मा प्रेजेंट, दिव्यांश जंगम
प्रेजेंट सर,
दिव्यांश कुमार
प्रेजेंट सर,
दिव्यांश शर्मा
प्रेजेंट सर,
फाल्गुनी नॉट देयर, हर्ष
प्रेजेंट सर,
हर्ष जैन हर्ष कुमार सिंह
प्रेजेंट सर,
या ओके हर्ष जैन मार्क किया नो प्रॉब्लम. हितेश चौधरी
प्रेजेंट सर,
इरापा सागरिका नॉट देयर, ईशान कौशिक नॉट देयर, मनीष मीणा मनु प्रताप सिंह मनु प्रताप नॉट देयर, मोहित शर्मा नंदिनी चौधरी
प्रेजेंट सर,
निहार
सर मनु
प्रेजेंट सर,
या नीन प्रेजेंट, नितिन
प्रेजेंट सर,
नूतन नूतन रेगार नॉट देयर, पीयूष नॉट देयर, प्रथम दिलीप
प्रेजेंट सर,
प्रियांशु प्रियांशु यादव
प्रेजेंट सर,
राहुल पाल नॉट देयर, सौरभ मीणा
प्रेजेंट सर,
मानस मानस मरु
प्रेजेंट सर,
शाहजबीन
खुश प्रेजेंट
सर, खुश रोल नंबर 37
हाँ, खुश मीणा
प्रेजेंट सर,
या अंकित
सर मैं रोल नंबर 24
सर, रोल नंबर 39
Wait, wait, wait. Sajabin present, yes. Ankit? Not there. Chanchal Kumari?
Present, sir.
Himanshu? Not there. Khushi Lodi? Sneha Sharma? Sneha Sharma present? Khushi Sharma?
Present, sir.
Section C. Aditi.
Present, sir.
Akshita Rao.
Present, sir.
Aman Ghazi Khan.
Present, sir.
Anjali Gaur.
Present, sir.
Anjali Vishwas.
Present, sir.
Bhavishya. भविष्य प्रेजेंट, भावना अमेटा
प्रेजेंट सर,
चांदनी
प्रेजेंट सर,
चारु रोल नंबर 9 नॉट देयर, हाँ चारु सुअलका प्रेजेंट, चारु वर्मा नॉट देयर, दर्शना हाँ दर्शना प्रेजेंट, ओके धीरेन्द्र कुमार नॉट प्रेजेंट, ध्वनि
प्रेजेंट सर,
सर रोल नंबर 4 प्रेजेंट लगा दिया था,
हाँ टेल मी आफ्टरवर्ड्स, गीतिका
प्रेजेंट सर,
देन जानवी सुरेश
प्रेजेंट सर,
जानवी ठाकुर
प्रेजेंट सर,
नेक्स्ट जोया खान नॉट देयर, ज्योत्सना
प्रेजेंट सर.
खुशबू नॉट देयर. खुशी अरोरा
प्रेजेंट सर.
लक्षिता
प्रेजेंट सर.
माधवी
प्रेजेंट सर.
मेहक
प्रेजेंट सर.
एंड एडलिन
प्रेजेंट सर.
नम्रता
प्रेजेंट सर.
नेक्स्ट नरेश चंद.
सर
नरेश चंद देयर.
यस सर.
वेरी गुड. नेक्स्ट रंजना चौधरी
प्रेजेंट सर.
रोशनी चौधरी
प्रेजेंट सर.
सलोनी गौतम
प्रेजेंट सर.
सौरभ
प्रेजेंट सर.
सृष्टि सिंह
प्रेजेंट सर.
सोनी कुमारी उदिता
प्रेजेंट सर.
विवेक
प्रेजेंट सर.
अनुज्ञा
प्रेजेंट सर.
विवेक के बाद अनुज्ञा है ना. नेक्स्ट कुमकुम
प्रेजेंट सर.
सलोनी प्रिया
प्रेजेंट सर.
ग्रेसी मेक मेघवाल 23 प्रेजेंट ओनली. ग्रेसी शर्मा ओके
तो प्रेजेंट 23.
देन हितेश कुमार
प्रेजेंट सर.
हेमा माइकल प्रेजेंट.
प्रेजेंट सर.
राजवी यादव
प्रेजेंट सर.
इशिता भटनागर नॉट देयर. आस्था द्विवेदी
प्रेजेंट सर.
तो रोल नंबर 23
23 ऑलरेडी मार्क्ड. ओके
फोर.
व्हाट रोल नंबर.
रोल नंबर 4
व्हिच सेक्शन.
सी.
अंजलि गौर मार्क्ड. ओके
सर. रोल नंबर 25
व्हिच सेक्शन.
सी.
नम्रता हो गई.
12th बी 24.
12th बी
24.
मनु प्रताप यू आर नॉट देयर कमिंग नाउ
सर. गया था सर भाई को टॉपिक में बोलने के लिए दिया हुआ था तो सर उसको बताने गया था.
दिस इज नॉट द वे यू हैव टू बी प्रेजेंट ऑल द टाइम. 5 मिनट जाना 5 मिनट आना दिस इज नॉट गुड. ओके कीप इन माइंड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स so we'll continue. Yeah, so these are three postulates which Bohr gave to explain the shortcomings of Rutherford's model. Now using these three postulates we can find those energy states. Okay, using these three postulates you can find which energy states the electron can stay in. Okay, so for example this is nucleus. This is some kind of orbit. So which energy state, what is the energy of electron here at which the electron can stay without radiating the energy, that energy state we are going to find. Okay, and for hydrogen atom we'll see. This is for hydrogen atom only. We already have calculated the energy state for your hydrogen atom, that is by taking your Bohr's model. And the energy was something like this for hydrogen atom. The energy state of your electron E was found to be minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught R. Okay, ये find किया था देखो previous class में, previous to previous class में find किया था. This was the expression. Now to find the energy state here. To find the energy state here, we need the value of R. Radius क्या है हमको पता चलना चाहिए. E charge of electron is known to us. 8 is a constant, pi is a constant, epsilon naught is a constant. Is everything is known to us. We need to find the radius. Okay, कौन सा radius में the electron? What is the radius around which the orbit of the radius of the orbit around which the electron revolves, that we need to find the radius we need to find. Okay, now to find that radius, how we can find the radius, we can make use of these postulates of your Bohr, that is Bohr's postulate to find the radius. Okay, so how we are going to find the radius, let us see that. Now we know about angular momentum. Angular momentum ka jo formula hai, L is equal to, we already know this is mvr, where r is the radius, v is the velocity, m is mass of the object. Okay, this we are going to use. Now let us use Bohr's second postulate. So Bohr's second postulate says that what Bohr's second postulate says, it relates your angular momentum. Okay, so says that only certain angular momentums are allowed. Okay, so electron can revolve around the nucleus only in those orbits where there are certain angular momentums that are integral multiple of something. Okay, that was the second postulate. No, so that it says that allowed values of angular momentum are, allowed values of angular momentum are momentum r. So what are those allowed values of angular momentum? Those are in fact integral multiple of h by, integral multiple of h by 2 pi. So basically I can write ln, where n represents the state, first state, second state, third state, like that. Okay, so ln is equal to m v n r n. Okay, so v n is velocity associated in that orbit, in that state. Similarly, r n is the radius of that orbit. Okay, radius of that as corresponding orbit. Okay, so that is equal to, in terms of the Bohr postulate, we can write n h by 2 pi. Okay, so m v n r n is equal to n h by 2 pi. Let it be equation 1, let this be equation 2. Okay, for the time being equation 2 डालेंगे इसको. So this is the expression which relates your angular momentum and whatever Bohr's postulate says about angular momentum. Okay, these two things. Okay, so here n is as usual integral multiples 1 2 3 4, कुछ भी हो सकता है, and v n is the velocity associated with that particular state, rn is the radius in that particular state. Okay, h Planck's constant 2 pi, everything is known to us now. Now let us move forward, and also we have got one expression for इसको रहने दो, इसका यूज करेंगे. ओके, या सो दिस एन, आई विल टेल हियर अबाउट एन ऑल्सो. एन कैन हैव वैल्यूज फ्रॉम 1 2 3, लाइक दिस, एनी वैल्यू इट कैन हैव. ओके, एन इज इक्वल टू 1 मीन्स फर्स्ट स्टेट, एन इज इक्वल टू 2 मीन्स सेकंड स्टेट, दैट इज सेकंड ऑर्बिट, एन इज इक्वल टू 3 मीन्स थर्ड ऑर्बिट, लाइक दैट. ओके, नाउ दिस एन, इसका जो वैल्यूज है, it is called as, you must have studied in chemistry also this thing, it is called as your, these are called as principal quantum number. Okay, principal quantum number. Okay, various quantum numbers you must have studied in chemistry, usme se this n, value of n 1 2 3 4 5, these represent your principal quantum number. Okay, now also we have the expression for velocity which we obtained by using Rutherford model. The velocity was vn, we can make use of velocity, let me write velocity of electron vn is equal to e by 4 pi epsilon naught mn rn. एन का जरूरत नहीं, मास इज कॉन्स्टेंट आर एन, दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर योर वेलोसिटी. Okay, now we can make use of equation 2 with, we can combine equation 2 with equation 3 to get the expression of velocity, and that comes out to be combining equation 2, this is 3, okay, in equation 3 we get, okay, isko combine karna hai. Now forget this m v n r n is equal to this much, so v n is equal to, take it down, okay, and then combine it here. Okay, only small mathematical calculation is there, I am not going to do, you can do it yourself, and it comes out to be v n is equal to, by combining this here, it comes out to be 1 by n e square by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by h by 2 pi. Okay, this is the expression you will get. Do some mathematical calculation, okay, that is your work, you can do to verify. So this is the expression for velocity which makes use of this Bohr's postulate as well. Okay, similarly the radius, you can also get the expression for radius rn, okay, and that comes out to be around, here rn is there, no, you can take this rn and then do all the calculation once again, and same thing you will get one more expression, and that comes out to be rn is equal to n square by m, then h by 2 pi whole square 4 pi epsilon naught by e square. So these two expression you will get by combining with your second equation, okay, that is the equation which relates your angular momentum with your Bohr's postulate. Okay, so by making use of this equation we will get two more expression, that is for your velocity and radius. Clear? Now that we have got both velocity and radius, we can find the energy state. Okay, so what will be that energy state? So first let us take the innermost orbit. Okay, let us take r1 means that is the innermost orbit. So r1 hum find kar sakte hain yahan se. Okay, so from this you can find r1, and that will be, substitute 1 here, if I substitute 1 and cancel this 2 pi with 4 pi cut karenge, okay, and anything else possible, then the equation will become this one, r1 is equal to h square epsilon naught by pi m e square. Okay, baki sab cancel ho jayega. So this is the expression that is your first orbit, expression for radius of the first orbit. Okay, iska ek naam diya gaya hai, that is your a naught. Okay, simply ek aise hi humne find kiya first orbit ka radius kya hai, uska ek expression. Okay, and now all the values of these things are known to us. You see, h is known to us, epsilon naught kya hai humko malum hai, pi value is known to us, mass of electron is known to us, charge of electron is known to us, everything is known to us. So if I substitute all the values here, then the radius of first orbit is found to be, okay, that calculation I am not doing, you can verify yourself. So if I substitute all the values here and do the calculation part, then it comes out to be around 5.29 × 10⁻¹⁰ m. So this is the radius of the first orbit of the electron in hydrogen atom, first stable orbit. Okay, not normal orbit we are talking about, first stable orbit, uska jo radius hai, it comes out to be this much. Clear? Now regarding the energy associated with the particular state, so let us come back to that expression, that is en is equal to, kya mila tha humko, minus what did we write, yeah, minus e square by 8 pi epsilon naught r. अभी r का हमको मिल गया rn, we have got the expression, so let us take it and combine it here, so we'll get a big expression, that is something like this, minus e square by 8 pi epsilon naught will be same only. Apart from that, क्या हो जाएगा n square by m reciprocal, everything इसको लेके reciprocal करके डालो इधर, है ना, m by n square then multiplied by 2 pi by h square and multiplied by e square by 4 pi epsilon. Okay, now we can simplify all these things. We can cancel some of the things. 2 pi square, 4 pi square. Here we have 8 pi, here we have 4 pi. Okay, these things can be cancelled. Clear? So all these things you can cancel. And finally, the expression will be something like this. Okay, these things can be cancelled here. 8 pi, 2 pi, either cut karo. You can do it yourself. Okay. I'm not going to do all those things. So then it comes out to be minus m e raised to the power 4 c square square 4 okay, divided by 8 n square epsilon naught square h square. Clear? This is the energy level of the particular state with numbers ranging from n. You can take 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. If you take n is equal to 1, then you'll get the energy associated with the first orbit. If you take n is equal to 2, then you'll get energy associated with the second orbit, likewise. Okay. And even it was found for first orbit. Orbit 1 ke liye find kiya gaya tha. Now, if I substitute all the values here, m ka value humko malum hai, mass of electron, charge of electron, n, let it be n for the time being. Epsilon naught ka value malum hai, h ka value malum hai. If I substitute these four values, only n ko constant rakhenge abhi, then again this expression can be written as something like minus 2.18 into 10 raised to minus 18 joule divided by n square. Divided by n square joule. Okay. Ye aata hai. Clear? And this is in fact in joule, so it can even be written as electron volt. Generally, in energy associated with electrons are written in electron volts, not in joule. Okay, so isko convert karenge electron volt se. Electron volt mein convert karna easy hai. One electron volt is how much? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joule. So 1 joule is equal to isko idhar leke aao, divide karo 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So basically, you have to multiply 1 by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 electron volt ho jayega. Okay, and then cut this mathematical part you can do, and it comes out to be minus 13.6 by n square electron volt. So this is the energy level of your electrons of hydrogen atom associated with different orbits. Okay, first orbit ke liye n is equal to 1 lena hai, second ke liye n is equal to 2, likewise. Clear? You can even find the energy associated with first orbit. You can find it yourself and check it, how much you are getting. Okay, for today we'll study this much only. Next class we'll continue. Okay, students, we'll meet you next class.
Thank you, sir.
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 Sir, please my mark attendance.